Integrating requires patience. Sometimes you can start attacking the monster, but it might take a little bit of time before you start to see success. Prepared to persevere, let's attack the indefinite integral of cosine x times e to the x dx. There's a metaphor here. There's really different ways to win the battle. Suppose this is you, and this is the integral that you're trying to attack. One way is, you know, to try to do it by hand, right? To take your shield and to take your sword and just to evaluate that integral directly by, say, going back to the definition of Riemann sum. But we almost never attack integrals in this way. Instead of using, you know, swords and shields, we're really using, you know, magic, right? We're putting on our wizard hat, and instead of trying to kill the integral, right? We're using something like U substitution to transform that integration problem into a friendlier integration problem that we can actually deal with, right? We're never attacking integrals directly. We're just transforming integrals by doing U substitution or parts. So let's try to transform the integral that we're attacking here. Let's transform e to the x cosine x into something else. So I'll use what? U, I'll make u be e to the x, because I don't really mind differentiating that. And I'll make dv cosine x dx. Now in that case, the derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. And what's an antiderivative of cosine? An antiderivative of cosine is sine. Now, what does integration by parts say? So then, antiderivative of cosine x e to the x dx is u times v, so e to the x sine x, minus the integral of v du, so sine x e to the x dx. Well, that didn't really help matters, but the word of the day is persevere. So let's persevere and transform that integral into yet another monster. So the new monster in this case is this thing here. Let's try the same trick on that new integral. So u will be e to the x again, and dv here will be just what's left over, sine x dx, and in that case, if u is e to the x, then du is e to the x dx, and if dv is sine x dx, well, I've got lots of choices for my antiderivative, but I'll have v be minus cosine x. Now let's put this into the integration by parts formula. So the antiderivative of sine x e to the x dx is uv, so minus e to the x cosine x, minus v du, so the integral of v du, so v is cosine x, and du is e to the x dx. Now what's happened thus far in the battle? I'm attacking this integral. I used integration by parts to transform the monster into something else. It didn't help. So I used that magical weapon again. I used integration by parts again to transform the integration problem into yet another integration problem. It didn't help. Or did it? Well, what happens if I put these two integration facts together? Well, then I've got here the integral of cosine x e to the x dx is equal to e to the x sine x minus the integral of sine x e to the x dx, which is down here, so minus negative e to the x cosine x plus the integral of cosine x e to the x dx. Let's persevere. Let's keep going. So this is saying the integral of cosine x e to the x dx is e to the x sine x plus e to the x cosine x minus the integral of cosine x e to the x dx. I'm going to add the integral of cosine x e to the x dx to both sides, and what I'll then get is 2 times the integral of cosine x e to the x dx is equal to, well, what's left on the right-hand side, e to the x sine x plus e to the x cosine x, and then I'll divide both sides by 2. And if I divide this side by 2 and this side by 2, well, then these 2's cancel, and I find out that an antiderivative of cosine x e to the x is e to the x sine x plus e to the x cosine x all over 2. What we did here is one of my favorite applications of integration by parts. We didn't use integration by parts to solve, to evaluate the integral directly. Instead, I applied parts twice and ended up with a clone of the original monster. So how did that go? Well, here you are, right? And you're a wizard. So here's your wizard hat. And here's the integral that we wanted to attack. But we didn't attack this integral directly. We didn't even transform this integral by using U substitution. Instead, we used parts twice. And it seemed like that was a terrible idea, because when I applied parts twice, I ended up with a clone of the original monster. The same integral ended up appearing. But that other integral came with a minus sign. And consequently, that monster ends up defeating itself, and we're able to evaluate the integral without actually integrating at all. If anything suggests that there's creativity in the battles ahead of us, I think integration by parts is telling us to be prepared to be amazed.